I'm Rachel with Simple Slides. With learning going digital for so many educators, one of the newest use cases for PowerPoint is virtual Bitmoji classrooms. Check the description below, we're giving away 100 plus Bitmoji classrooms for free. In this video, we're going to show you step by step how to create your own Bitmoji classroom. Hi, it's Rachel with Simple Slides. With learning going digital for so many educators, one of the newest use cases of PowerPoint is making virtual Bitmoji classrooms. Check the description below for 100 plus slides for free. Virtual classrooms create a fun and interactive option to display your presentations. Usually, these include elements such as chalkboards or whiteboards, along with furniture and other interesting design pieces of your choice. Let's show you how to make Bitmoji classrooms step by step. As you can see, it's a simple virtual classroom composed of elements such as a chalkboard, a table, a laptop, a book, a bookshelf, a clock, a bulletin board with the attached hyperlink, a television with a video inside, and of course, our little Bitmoji. The first thing I did was open Google and search for wall and floor backgrounds. As you can see, there are a lot of different wall and floor backgrounds you can use, but for our example, I've chosen this design. All we have to do now is right-click and select Copy Image, then paste the copied image on an empty slide. Position the background and scale it by dragging its edges so that it can fit the whole slide. It's okay if it's a little stretched. Now let's add our Bitmoji. Once you have downloaded the Bitmoji app and created your avatar on your phone, you must download the Bitmoji extension on Google Chrome. Once installed, click on the extension button on the upper right and select the Bitmoji extension. Here, you have tons of Bitmoji stickers to choose from, and you have a search bar at the top of it if you want to look for a specific pose. I chose this standing Bitmoji with the three hearts. Just right-click and select Copy Image, then you go to your slide and paste the Bitmoji. Here, you can scale the Bitmoji to the size you want. I don't want these three hearts, so I decided to crop them out. Just go to Format, select Crop Image, and then crop the image to your liking. Now to add the chalkboard. Go to Google and type in chalkboard pink. Make sure to end your search items with PNG or transparent so that you get an image result that has a transparent background. I've already picked out our chalkboard pink, as well as other elements with transparent backgrounds beforehand. Just copy the image and paste it onto the slide. Afterwards, you can move it around to reposition the image, as well as scale it to the size of your liking. As you can see, the chalkboard seems to be overlapping our Bitmoji. To fix this, right-click on the Bitmoji and select Bring to Front. That way, our Bitmoji will be on top of the chalkboard. Now for the table. Just like the chalkboard, search for a table ping and choose an image with no background. Once selected, copy the image and paste it on our slide. Resize and reposition the image to your preference. Do the same process for the laptop, book, bookshelf, bulletin board, clock, rug, and television. Now, I want to add a video inside our television element. To do this, go to Insert, click Video, and select Online Video. From there, I selected YouTube, and then search for the video that I desired. Once selected and inserted, I resized the video to fit exactly inside the television. You can also add text on your Bitmoji classroom. I will add a text and place it inside the chalkboard. Simply go to Insert, then Shapes. From there, select Add Text Box. In the text box, place the text that you wish to display, then resize and reposition as necessary. Now, I'll add another text box, which I'll place inside the bulletin board. This one will be hyperlinked to a web address. To do this, simply type in your text, resize it, and reposition it inside the board. Once done, click on the text box, or highlight the entire text. Then right-click and select Hyperlink. From there, go to Existing File or Web Page. Place your web address on the tab below labeled Address. I copied the link to Simple Slides' YouTube channel and placed it there, then hit OK. As you can see, the text has now been hyperlinked. Clicking on it during a presentation takes you to the web address you entered. And there you have it! We're giving away free over 100 Bitmoji classrooms to teachers. Just subscribe to our YouTube channel below and find the link in the description. Thanks to XXIs for the tutorial. Check out his channel in the description for more PowerPoint videos.